Hi, I'm Lee Kerry and I hope you enjoy this video. Keep watching because there's going to be a special opportunity to win some of the tackle that I'm using today. Join me today on a typical winter's day's fishing. And what I really want to focus on today is when you go on a commercial, when it's really cold, is that mentality on how fish move about and they're not always going to stay in one place and how you've got to find them throughout the day. I'm at the wonderful Oaks Fishery today and it's very typical, my session today, of probably a lot of lakes that you might go fishing on where you've got a little bit of room in front of you. It's winter, there's less people on the bank. You know, even in matches, there'll probably be a little bit more room than there would be in summer. And you'll have a little bit of room to fish into, but the fish will naturally back off into the quieter areas of the lake. So you've got to really use a bit of watercraft to catch them. But the approach itself can be really simple, and that's what I want to get across today. So I've got a very simple setup, as you can see. I've got with me my ever faithful 10-foot Superior SL, which is a really, really soft rod for winter fishing. Now, it's really important to have a nice soft rod because you could be catching F1s or carp or bream, skimmers, whatever it might be. Everything doesn't fight as hard in the winter, okay? Fish, they don't, you know, you hook them, they lollop about a little bit, and if you've got a stiff rod with barbless hooks, those fish are going to shake off. So a nice soft rod is absolutely crucial, okay? So on my soft rod, all I've got is an ICM stem. Now, this is all I need for today. I only need this one rod to search and work my peg because I've got a lot of variety with this stem. I can put a bomb, a little banjo feeder, a method feeder, cage feeder, maggot feeder. I've got lots of options with this stem. But for me today, there's two primary ways of approaching the peg that I'm going to use. And the first will be with a bomb, and then I will look to introduce a little bit of feed with a banjo. And we'll talk about that as we go and how we're going to manipulate the peg. So it's a really easy setup. I've got a little ICM bead in here, which fits snugly in the bottom here. Just gives you a little, almost semi sort of fix. It's not fixed, but it just locks it in place nice and tidy there at the bottom. It's really nice. I've put a longer hook length on to start with because we're going to be starting with bread. And I've got a 6-pound mainline, 023, sinking feeder mono. I still like something a little bit more durable. You don't need to go too light, especially when you're looking at carp. I like to keep a nice durable line. And I've got that on my 520 centrist reel. So a super, super easy setup. Let's take a little look at the peg and let's look at where we're gonna start. So the water in front of me today is typical of a commercial fishery that maybe you might go to. It's not a particularly massive, big expanse of water. It's a nice sized lake with plenty of good stock fish in it. So, you know, wherever you chuck about, there's gonna be a few fish there because they've got nowhere really to go. But you've got to manage your space well because the fish will naturally move about. So I've got nobody opposite me today, which could be typical of winter fishing. Often lakes are pegged just one bank, or if you were pleasure fishing, you might not have anybody opposite you. So I've got the scope to go as far as the far bank, but I've got to be honest, I don't really want to do that. I want to try and keep as tight to myself as I can. The fish are naturally going to want to back away from me at this time of year. So I've got that in my mind. You can see I've got an aerator slightly to the right. So I have got a feature somewhere near my peg, which is nice. Can also see a few bubbles coming up to my left because I know they've got some underwater bits in here as well, which add oxygen. So maybe that's going to be a slight feature. So I've got a couple of little features to work at. But to start with, I'm going to go as close as I dare where I think I might get a bite. Now, if it was a little bit warmer, I would be going really close, like 5 meters, something like that. But It's absolutely bitter here today. It was all frozen over in the puddles this morning. So I know that I'm not going to probably catch a fish too close. Now, after about 13 meters here, it shallows up very slightly. And the fish are naturally going to gather, I would say, in the middle of the lake. So that'll probably be typical of where you might go fishing. So you might want to come this side of where you think you're going to catch your fish. So closer towards you. And that's where I'm going to start. So I don't know what's going to happen. I've got absolutely no idea. But I will talk you through my little bomb and bread approach. I've got two bombs in the ICM. I've got a 10 gram bomb and I've got a 20 gram bomb. Now, for me, when I'm bread fishing, it's absolutely essential that I have a heavier weight. I believe that fish need to hook themselves against the weight of the bomb when you're fishing with bread, because as I put this bomb on now, I'll show you how the setup works. Effectively, and I can just slide this bomb here onto my stem, look, into the middle, slide her on. Okay, so that's my 20 gram bomb locked in place on my stem. What I've done is I've got an 8-inch hook length there, which is my typical bread hook length. Just take this this bread up here so you can see it. I've got my bread in my punch box. I'm gonna go for the 8mm. That's my usual starting size. To be honest, it's the one I focus on most of all. So I'll get this 8mm. I'm just gonna punch out a couple of pieces here. I think a couple of pieces of nice, thick, stodgy bread is all you need. I tend to punch them both in the same one. And I know that's going to sound a bit weird, but I want them to come out nicely together like that, look. All right, so that's a really nice little bread punch there. I'll get my needle, pop it in the rapid stop. And I'm just going to push that through in the middle, like so. And that bread will really puff up on the bottom. Those two bits of 8mm bread will really puff up. Now they're gonna float when I chuck them in. So when I chuck it in, the bread will be popped up like this off the bottom. Now if you didn't have a heavy weight on the bottom, as the fish picks that bread up, the 10 gram weight probably isn't heavy enough to hook most fish. I think the extra weight that you've got in the 20 gram is gonna help you. I often use 30 when I'm on a bigger, deeper venue. 20 will be absolutely fine for today, chucking close, but that's the sort of thing that I'm looking for. Now, if I was going to fish with like corn or a pellet on like a loose fed line, that's when that 10 gram bomb comes in, because it's different. The bait lies on the bottom, everything's quite direct. The fish picks it up and it hooks itself almost against the rod as much as it does the bomb. But when you're fishing with bread and the bread is off the bottom, the fish hooks itself against the weight. So all I'm going to do to start with, and this is a nice little tip for you, I don't want to make a great big racket with my bomb. I don't want to cast too far. So I tend to put a slightly longer length of line than I normally would when I cast. And that's going to sound a little bit weird, but it helps me almost like loop my bomb out nicely. So I'm just going to do that now. I'm going to literally loop it out as close as I dare. There we go. Probably about 14 and a half meters, something like that. And that is going to give me a chance of an early fish. Now, always get your rod set up on the butt rest. Get yourself nice and comfortable. You're going to be waiting. I need a stopwatch because I think that's important whenever I'm fishing. So I've started my stopwatch and I'm looking now for indications on my tip. So my tip isn't set slack. When I'm fishing with bread, I like to have my tip set like with a nice bend on it, because a lot of the time you can find that the bites are quite drop backy. So the fish picks it up, it shakes its head. And as it shakes its head, it dislodges the bomb and the bomb drops back. And if you haven't got a bend in your rod for doing that, then in my opinion, you don't hook as many fish, because they sort of, like I said, hook themselves against the bomb. So by having that little bend in the tip, it allows me to see what's going on. Now, I'll just shut my punch box up so my bread doesn't dry out. While I get comfortable here, over the next 10-15 minutes, I'm going to be looking for signs of liners, signs of fish. All right, I'm hoping for an early fish, but I will leave this at least 10 minutes on my first cast. For a start off, I think there's a good chance those fish will naturally back away from where I've cast my bomb. It might take them a little while just to creep a little bit closer. But during that time, I'm going to be glued to my tip and I'm going to be looking for signs of fish moving. Is there any signs of fish moving anywhere? Maybe a little bit further out in the edge. Look, one's just topped right over where I've chucked the bomb amazingly. That's amazing. So that's given me a ton of confidence there that there's fish in the area, because I haven't seen a fish move the whole time I've been setting up. And there's one topped just on my bomb and one's just topped a little bit further out, which just goes to show they know I'm here, because I haven't seen a single fish top while I've been setting up. But since that bomb's just gone in and one has topped, so the fish know I'm here. So it's going to be interesting how the next 10, 15 minutes or so pans out. Right, so I've had 2 10-minute chucks. First one you saw was probably about 14 meters. I've just gone about 15 meters, 16 meters, tiny little bit further, still nothing. So it's really important for me to sort of like, I don't want to just go, oh yeah, I got one there, it's easy. I want you to see how it works in winter. It's not always easy. We're 20 minutes in, we've not had a bite. Now I'm going to go a little bit further. I'm going to go to what I consider the middle of the lake, because carp can shoal so tightly. Okay, that often you just need to go that little bit further in order to catch them. So this time I've gone what I consider middle of the lake, all right, which is probably, I'm gonna say 70. I had a liner there just as I was tightening up. Wow, I haven't had a liner on those other two chucks. 17 or 18 meters, that's interesting. Just pop my rod down here. So I'm gonna tighten that rod up like I did before. Another liner, big drop back. Wow, there's fish there for definite. I've just had 2, and there you go. That's unbelievable. That is unbelievable. I reckon I've cast out there. I reckon I've cast out there probably 4 meters further than my 2 casts before. Like, first one was, like I say, 14, 16. That was probably 20 meters. I've had 2 liners within seconds of it hitting the bottom, and I've got a fish on straight away. That is an amazing summary of winter fishing and why I think it's so important to start with a single bait with no feed. Because what I wouldn't have wanted to do is I wouldn't have wanted to feed my peg with that banjo feeder at 14 and 16 meters. I want to try and find the fish first, and straight away there it was so obvious that that's where the fish are, because I've just had 2 indications. And I, you know, we saw a fish top slightly the other side of middle as well. So I mean, that is unbelievable how quickly I've had a bite there. I mean, it was in the water 30 seconds and 2 or 3 indications and straight round. That soft rod's doing me a lot of favours here. I've not gone heavy on the hook length, by the way, guys. I've actually gone 014 on the hook length. I haven't gone really heavy because, you know, it's winter time, and I just believe that when your bread's popped up, that light hook length's going to do me a bit of favour. So that nice soft rod, look at the action there, all the way through the rod. Just take my time with a nice soft clutch. This fish is still quite feisty, to be fair. Quite feistier than I thought, maybe, for a winter special. Here he comes, right in the chops. Got him. There we go. So look, nice snap of fish, really nice. Probably like 3.5 pounds, something like that. Hooked perfectly there, look, where it's taking the bread. What a brilliant example of using your space in winter fishing. It's really important, all right, to use that space and find where the fish are. I'm pretty confident now I'll be able to chuck out and get another one in that spot, because there was liners there. It wasn't just one fish there for definite, but a good example of finding the fish first. Straight straight back in. 1 minute 30 on the clock. Another fish. Such a powerful way of fishing. Such an unbelievable way of fishing in the winter. I mean, the difference between that, do you know what always gets me with this style of fishing? If you go and try and do this in the warmer months, it just doesn't work because the fish are so feeding such a different way. This is fish that are feeding on opportunity. They're feeding on sight. You know, they're seeing that bread almost right in front of them. They just can't resist. Just crazy how, pretty mirror there, look at that, straight again, straight in the bottom lip, no problems at all. I got a 16 KKM hook is my preferred hook for that. I want something slightly lighter than the KKH because I don't want that, I want that bread to pop up. So the 16 KKM is my hook, and you can see that just wedged in the bottom there. It's working perfectly at the moment. I'm hopefully going to enjoy a little session at this distance, see how many we can get before we have to start mixing it up a little bit. So as you've seen, I've been using the ICM system today. Amazing little system. This is your chance to win an ICM bundle. So what I want to know is, because I'm not going to give them away to anyone, are we? I want to know where you're going to use these bits. Comment below in the comment section where you're going to use them. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and you will have a chance to win an amazing ICM bundle. Okay, right, I've had a brilliant run, to be honest. I think I've got about 10 carp. Fantastic fishing. I caught 6 or 7 pretty much as quick as I could after you left me. Really nice. I really enjoyed it, to be fair. But the last 2 or 3 have taken longer. The fish are still there. I'm getting liners and indications. Now, on another day, I might have cast around with a bomb. Let's say I'd have caught 2 fish where I'm chucking. I might have searched my peg a little bit more, but we're 1.5 hours in. It's warm. You know, I've got 10 carp in the net, or I say it's warm. It's getting warmer. The sun's been on me now for a good 1.5 hours. I'm not as cold as I was. And I think maybe the fish might want that little bit of food as well. So before I sort of go searching for any sort of fish, I think a change could be in order here, like to this little banjo, and I'm just going to show you how I do that. So I've taken my hook length off, I've got that bomb on, and I just literally have to push that sleeve up off the stem and slide the bomb up, and there you can see I just take that off the line. And I've prepared myself a little 15 grand banjo XR, beautiful feeder. Don't want loads of bait, we've been catching on the bread as it is. Push that down. Look, I'm almost ready to go. So I'm just going to put a hook length on that I want here. I'm going to go for an 18 KKM because I'm going to go with a single maggot. It's my favourite winter bait. So I've got it 4 inches long, like you normally would for banjo fishing. Let's pop that on my quick change bead. And literally, you're watching all this real time. This is how long it takes me to change over. So now I'm ready to go, aren't I? So I've got some red maggots in here. I'm really interested to see what their response is going to be, because I don't see why they wouldn't be on the hunt for a little bit of food now, you know, because like I say, it's just warmed up that little bit. So put my maggot in, and all I do when I'm winter fishing is I get my pellets and I just scoop the banjo in them, so it's sort of like that, little flattened down with my thumb. Not too hard. When it's winter, I don't think your bait's as active. And just lay my maggot there, look, in the middle, and then put a few more on top, and I mean a few, literally like 10 or so, and just hold that maggot on top like that. All I want to do, I kind of don't want to cover him up, I just want to hold him in. So when he gets to the bottom, those few loose pellets are breaking up. I mean, talk about a winter trap. That is literally as good as it gets. So I'm going to cast it where I've been catching the fish, which is about 20 meters. I'm sure there's still fish there, but it's going to go hopefully in with a nice little gentle plop. Oh, absolutely perfect. Better than my bomb, that. I actually felt a fish there, and there's still fish there. That's what I mean. It's almost like they've got a bit wary of the bomb. Those last 3 fish took probably about 40 minutes to catch, which I know doesn't seem too long, but there's a lot of fish in here. Bearing in mind my first three fish took about 5 minutes to catch once I found them. So look, you see there's still odd indications there. So let's see if they want to go and eat some bait instead. I'm hoping that they will. Look at that as a liner. There's so many fish there. I'm just going to slacken it off a little bit. It's how I like to fish when I fish with a... If we got one now, I'd be thinking, well, it's a really positive change. And it goes to show that they do want some food at certain times of the day. You know, we're getting on for the warmest part now. It's warmed up, approaching midday. Two minutes, 15 seconds on the clock, and we've got him. I just had that feeling that little bit of bait was gonna be what they wanted now. Those fish are there for sure. The tip was crazy compared with the bomb. They were there with the bomb, but not the same as that. They were definitely round that feed, like really fast. Like, yeah, we want a bit of food now. We're ready for a bit of food. So you saw that explosive start on the bomb. And if I can back this up now with, say, another 10 fish throughout the session on the... Oh, yes. On the Banjo XR, on the old mini one. Look at him. These are lovely fish. I've had a few like that today. They're good fish, they are. You know, look at that for winter fish. He's £4 every bit of him. Look, nailed. Got in there, bottom lip. 18, people maybe not go as small as that, but I like to. Single maggot on that Banjo. That is absolutely perfect. What a brilliant, brilliant session this has turned out to be. So, I hope you've enjoyed this video today. Follow the advice that I've given you, and I'm sure on your local commercial, you could enjoy a fantastic day just like I've had here at the Oaks.